students enter college, we've got to make sure that we see more students successfully earn a college degree. But what we've done over the past year represents enormous progress. So I'll close by saying this. For a long time, our student loan system has worked for banks and financial institutions. Today, we're finally making our student loan system work for students and our families. But we're also doing something more. From the moment I was sworn into office, I've spoken about the urgent need for us to lay a new foundation for our economy and for our future. And two pillars of that foundation are health care and education, and each has long suffered from problems that we chose to kick down the road. With the bill I signed last week, we finally undertook meaningful reform of our health care system. With this bill and other steps we've pursued over the last year, we are finally undertaking meaningful reform in our higher education system. So this week, we can rightly say the foundation on which America's future will be built is stronger than it was 1 year ago. And so at the end of this extraordinary week, I want to acknowledge some of the people who made it possible. There isn't time to single out everyone who's here, outstanding members of Congress, but I want to make sure I once again say this would not have happened had it not been for the leadership of Speaker Nancy Pelosi. Senate Majority Leader Harry Reid. Senator Dick Durbin and Congressman Steny Hoyer all provided outstanding leadership that our nation needed. On health care, Max Baucus, Chris Dodd, Henry Waxman, Charlie Rangel, and so many others offered invaluable expertise throughout the year. Congressman George Miller, Jim Clyburn, Dale Kildee, Ruben Hinojosa led the way in the House on education reforms that I signed today. Senator Tom Harkin's dedication ensured that the Senate would include these reforms in this bill. Virginia's own Bobby Scott and an outstanding freshman, Tom Perriello, helped to make this thing possible. We are grateful to them. Now, courage is an essential ingredient in any landmark legislation, particularly when the attacks are as fierce and unrelenting and inaccurate as they have been over the past year. So I just want to commend members of Congress who had the courage to do what's right, and to say a special thank you to all the newer members. You know, the past couple of years have brought one challenge after another. And you've risen to the moment each time. I could not be prouder of the work that all of you have done. And it would not have happened had it not been for the incredible persistence and stick-to-itiveness of all the folks in the audience here today. You know, ultimately, Congress responds to the voices that they're hearing in their communities. And so many of you have written letters and come to meetings and let people know of the ordinary struggles that people are going through each and every day. You're what provided members of Congress the courage that they needed to do what was right. And so on behalf of all of us who are serving in Washington, we want to thank you, the American people, for your outstanding leadership. And with that, I'm going to sign this bill. Thank you very much.
President Obama signing in the health reform fix-it bill using several pens, as he always did. Nancy Pelosi on stage with him, Arne Duncan. Mike Vaccara is at the White House right now. And Mike, I wanted to see what you made of the president's speech. You know, not one Republican voted for this bill, the original health care bill, nor the one with the tweaks. The president says that the Republicans have sort of drawn a line in the sand here, deciding this is all about politics. What are the thoughts inside the White House about this division in Washington now moving forward with their agenda?
Well, you heard the president in his speech lay claim to two major victories in 1 week, and certainly two signing ceremonies with a rapturous audience, smiles all around, a joyous and jubilant crowd, at least there in the hall, and last week here in the East Room when he signed the base legislation. I think many Democrats and people in the White House view this past week, or hope to view it, when they look back at it, as an inflection point, as sort of a transition point between the long and grueling, I think the president called fierce and sometimes inaccurate charges that were made over the course of this year-long, this 14-month debate over health care, and now moving on. You saw the president, of course, make that surprise trip to Bagram Airfield and Kabul, Afghanistan over the weekend, surrounded by a similarly enthusiastic crowd of men and women in uniform. You'll see him hit the road again later this week for another rally on health care in Maine, and then something on the economy on Friday in North Carolina, the same day that the new unemployment figures for last month come out, as a matter of fact. And you will also hear Republicans continue their new mantra now, post-vote, post-signing ceremony, of repeal and replace. And to that extent, I think we're going to see in the fall when voters will decide where they come down on this legislation that was signed today, Jeff.
And yet over the weekend, there was a Washington Post poll that shows that this didn't help President Obama much with public acceptance of this plan.
And exactly right. I think that poll in the Washington Post showed that while 46% of Americans support the health care reform plan that the president has just signed into law, 50% oppose it. And among the most passionate people on both sides of the debate, most of them are on the side of the opposition, Jeff.
NBC's Mike Vaccara at the White House.